1982, I went to visit General Quiwonkpa. He said, "Koma, go talk to your friend, because we planned to go back to the barracks. We planned to go back to the barracks after the elections. But some people pushing him. Some people pushing him to want to run." I said, "But he's your best friend. You people were together vis-a-vis the others. We're saying the others who were executed. Now you split up." He said, "I know, but the people around him." So we all agreed that we'll meet that Sunday morning at the mansion, so that we could talk this over and find out what was happening. General Clark said we should meet. Doe agreed, Quiwonkpa agreed. When I got there at 9:45, Thomas Quiwonkpa was coming down, descending the stairs. I said, "What happened?" He said, "Go ask your man." I said, "Who Quiwonkpa saying go ask your man? Who gonna go upstairs there?" I found out from those who were around there that head of state Doe had called a meeting and announced the transfer of General Quiwonkpa to the Capitol Building as Secretary General of the People's Redemption Council, and I quickly appointed General Morris Zizi as the next commanding general. Quiwonkpa obviously was not pleased, but at that point never openly refused. In short, that led to a serious schism within the PRC. In the end, General Quiwonkpa had to flee. Then we heard the Nima raid involving Samuel Doe took place, and that some people were killed, relatives of Charles Julu. Sometime later, I was dismissed as Assistant Minister of Information. I spent only 3 months, as Minister of Information. I had come after 82, served as Director General of the Liberia Broadcasting System, and then later on appointed as Minister. I spent only 3 months at the ministry. That was one of the most critical and dangerous moments. It was a time that Vice Head of State Podia, Eva Sawyer, and a number of people had been jailed. General Gray D. Allison, Minister of Defense, when the students started protesting against the arrest of Sawyer, ordered the movement of the soldiers onto the campus of the university. And I saw rattans in the hands of the soldiers besides their guns, because there was a casket being displayed right at the mouth of the University of Liberia campus by the students, saying that that was the casket of Doe. So the soldiers ran after them onto the campus. That night, we heard that some shooting had taken place on the campus and that some people had been killed. I was Minister of Information. At 9 o'clock in the night, we have sent our reporters to the various hospitals and clinics to find out the situation, whether people have been killed or wounded. I called my colleague in the cabinet, Minister of Health, Martha Sandolo Bele, to give me up-to-date report on what was happening at the hospitals and clinics. And I told her, please be honest to me. Has anybody been killed? And she said, not to her recollection of any information. So about 11 o'clock, I was still at the office. Because this was a grave day in the history of Liberia. Helter skelter. So I called head of state Doe. I said, excuse me, sir. Have you got any information that anybody has been killed? He said, no. Who you follow this rumor that going around town? Whole minister like you? I said, no, I'm asking you. I'm not making a statement.